Welcome to this really exciting conversation that we will be having where we're looking at an amazing online resource from our partners over at Teva Pharmaceutical called Honestly HD. And so this is a really great online resource, as I mentioned, to really help families, caregivers, people who are impacted by HD personally, a chance to dive a little bit deeper into some very specific topics that are important to the HD community. But first off, I wanted to introduce Christine, and thanks so much for joining us. And Christine, would you be willing to share a little bit about yourself?
Sure. Thanks, Jenna. Hi, I'm Christine Foy. I work in consumer marketing for Teva Pharmaceuticals and have been with the company for just about 2 years. That'll be in June. I do live in South Jersey with my fiance and our dog, a mini Bernedoodle named Kevin. We all enjoy being outside together. We hike, we camp, just spending as much time as we can just outdoors, just keeping active.
That's amazing. So for those watching, that is New Jersey in the U.S., not Jersey as a part of the U.K. So just want to start.
Yeah, Jersey in the U.S.
Oh, and I know we have a lot of dog lovers who are watching, so I'm sure you have an equal swoon as people are listening along. Well, we always love to start off these interviews by understanding, how did you come to be involved with the HD community?
Yeah, so for about the past decade, I've actually specialized in marketing and advertising, dedicating most of my time focusing in the rare disease space. So I've gotten to see a couple different aspects of that. But through my role specifically with Teva, I've had the privilege of becoming involved with this inspiring and super close-knit community. Interacting with these individuals has been incredibly rewarding for me personally. It's offered me the opportunity to connect with, listen to, and really learn from different individuals.
Yeah, that's fantastic. And thanks so much for your emphasis on rare diseases throughout your career. It's really important that we have people who are there to support and listen and to build these types of programs to really help propel this community, especially when it comes to things like making your best decisions and empowering you individually. Well, let's get right to the meat of the conversation. So let's talk a little bit about Honestly HD. So how was that developed? What were some of the conversations and reasons why Honestly HD was developed?
Yeah, so I cannot take all the credit for this. There are quite a few people involved. A lot of my colleagues were at the beginning of this. So initially, Honestly HD began as a Facebook group where members of the community could come and have discussions about HD Korea. So as we saw the growth of the membership and the engaging conversations that were had on just that platform, the need was recognized that there's more information that the community is looking for. So from that, honestlyhd.com was created. It's an educational website that aims to provide information, inspiration, and resources to help people understand what to expect with HD Korea and how to talk to their healthcare provider about preserving that independence.
What were some of those conversations like that you heard from the Facebook group? I know that they wanted more information, but were there specific concerns that they felt like education was lacking, or areas that they really wanted to see more focused and represented?
I think because it was just community-based conversations, there's overlapping frequently asked questions. And if there was a hub or a platform where this information could be housed, it's easier to find and dig into that information a little bit more instead of waiting for someone to respond to your comment or maybe not necessarily getting the answers that you're looking for.
Mm-hmm. So it's really taking some of just the knowledge around Korea and turning it into something that could be easily accessed from whenever and wherever you needed it. That's great. So what can people find at Honestly HD? What are some of the things that are developed there as resources? And I know you continually add more and more each year.
Yes. Yeah, so beyond just information about HD Korea, there are a variety of resources to support people living with HD. We want to provide steps to help people decide how and when to address their HD Korea. We have things like an HD Korea discussion guide to help prepare for doctor's appointments. We have stories of others in the community that about their personal experiences. Since we know that each person's experience is unique, we want them to feel that they're not alone in this journey. And then we do have a new tool. It's called the Korea, the HD Korea Independence Planner. So this was actually, to your point, was just recently added to the website.
So let's break some of those down a little bit themselves. So I think one of the things that can be really daunting is when families go into a doctor's appointment, and we hear all the time that there's a list of things that people want to ask, but they don't always think about it when they're in the middle of the appointment, or other things get brought up, or, you know, because there's such a little time that people do get with their neurology and their medical team. So what are some of the things that are on that guide in order to prepare people to go into these appointments, and questions that they should be asking?
Yeah, sure. And I think that's important as we talk about preserving independence too, is when you want to have that conversation. So I think the important thing is deciding when you're ready to have that conversation, and then what to have during that conversation. So things like what treatments are available to help me with my HD chorea, what to expect as the chorea progresses, just setting the expectations up front of what to expect as HD chorea progresses throughout the HD journey.
Yeah. So it's really just to help put some of those commonly asked questions in one place, in order for people to have something to take away with them and take notes and things like that. And I think this is really important to go in, because there are a lot of different personalities that people take when talking with their medical team. Sometimes they just say, whatever you recommend, I'll follow you. Mm-hmm. Some people are a little bit in the middle of that. Some people want to go in and to really be hands-on. And to be very active in how they decide for their treatment. So I think that these tools are really helpful, no matter which one of those categories you fit in, to be able to have those conversations. And you know, let's face it, talking to neurologists can be really intimidating. So I think added preparation is really key there.
Oh, for sure. I think any one of us going to a doctor's appointment, you prepare, but you know, when you get to the office, to your point, you're not necessarily remembering everything. So if you just, even if you have a question on the list that you bring with you, it might spur some other questions to bring up with your physician.
Yeah. And I think that's also really important, considering the fact that cognition is often impacted with people who are gene positive. And so just having those organizational tools, or even if there are family members who can't attend the appointment and they have questions, I think it's important to really include your whole team of friends or family who are there to support you, because they may have questions that you don't think about. Mm-hmm. Now, I think this is really important. And one of the things that's brand new is this planning for independence section. So you talked a little bit about this, but let's dive a little bit deeper. So what was the thought process and reason why this was created? And then how can people use this resource?
Sure. This goes back to Korea comes at different times for people. So we just want everyone to know that proactively planning to preserve their independence is something that they can own. This planner really gives them the opportunity to choose when they're ready to have that conversation, to talk with their doctor about treatment. So the resource includes questions about an individual's personal HD journey and captures those responses, and then offers suggestions on how to plan for chorea. So like I said, it's designed to help decide when and how to address HD chorea before your movements begin, and then reinforces the importance of planning ahead to maintain that independence and manage your chorea.
Mm-hmm. So looking at it, some of those things that are important would be like probing questions for yourself. So one of the first questions is, what are some tasks and activities you do every day that you want to keep doing? So I think that's important for what does independence mean individually to each person? Mm-hmm. And there's also an other section. And then are you concerned with your ability to currently perform these tasks? And I think sometimes when people are watching this, they may think, well, I don't have any chorea symptoms yet. But I think it's really important to even still look at these things if you're gene positive and don't have symptoms, because it may be future planning. And to have those conversations too with loved ones, to say, these are the important things that I want to continue to do. Let's create a plan around how I can do that for as long as possible.
Exactly. Yeah. And once someone completes this, they are armed with a PDF that they can have. And as they start to see some of these things that they've checked, they want to check off, they can, that's the opportunity that they can download a discussion guide and schedule time with their provider to maybe talk about what the next steps are.
So what happens after they complete this? Do they get an email report? Is there something that they can download themselves?
Yep. So it'll be once the form is completed, it's included with all the responses that the individual put in. It's combined with little helpful tips and recommendations at the bottom about planning ahead. And then you can download it, you can email it to yourself. So there is a physical copy that you can have.
Yeah, I think that's really great. And I think it's important to note too, that this will change. So you can catalog when you completed it, what the responses are. And then as life is happening, you can make those adjustments because, you know, the level of importance may be adjusted based off of what's going on behind the scenes as well.
Absolutely.
Well, what are some of the other things? I know that you all have stories of hope too, and some other educational videos, which are just so empowering. What are some of your takeaways from those particular pieces?
Yeah. So just a couple of takeaways from our website. We really want individuals who come to Honestly HD just to gain a deeper understanding of HD Korea, its symptoms, and the available resources to make those informed decisions about not only their health, but the health of a loved one if they are taking care of someone. We do hope that they'll find a sense of community, knowing that they're not alone in this journey. And that's where I think the stories of hope that are, you know, that we've shared so far are different perspectives of people living with HD and impacted by HD. So we hope they find some sort of hope and motivation just in these experiences from others.
I'm curious, this isn't something that that I let you know ahead of time, but what are some of the things that you personally have taken away by listening to these different stories and being engaged with the HD community?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I've been here about 2 years. I've gotten to be able to be a part of this community right off the bat. Just the opportunity to meet everyone has given me such perspective. I didn't realize how close everyone in this community was, but it's been inspiring for me as an individual who I may not personally be impacted by HD, but, you know, working in the space and rare disease space really gives me that sense of hope and the perspective to just continue to move forward every day.
Yeah, it is such a tight-knit community. You're absolutely right. And the level of support and love that everybody has for them, for each other is so powerful. And we see that a lot, especially with our ambassadors who globally are there to support each other. And whenever they message each other and have a challenge or something comes up, you just have this swarm of people around you. And that is very indicative of the culture of this community, no matter where you are, which is really powerful and important.
Yeah, super amazing. And it, every time I speak with someone and it's their different perspective is always eye-opening, and just knowing that we are unique and we are personal, but there might be something that touches me, even though I'm not impacted, but it might touch you too. So just, it's very incredible.
Well, and I suffer from the same thing that you keep saying, where you're not familially impacted, but we are impacted because we know and love so many people who are affected or who may be symptomatic or who have loved ones who are. So you are impacted, and it's important to be a part of this community, and you do play an important role in that.
Thank you.
Well, so absolutely. How can people get involved? I know that that this tool, so just to share this again, this is it's available online. So no matter where you are from, whatever country, you do have access to this. It's an important tool to consider at any age, or if you wanted to learn more about Korea in general or hear other stories. But so how can people get further involved with what you all are working on?
Yeah, for sure. We love everyone to get involved. So one of the first things is just visiting honestlyhd.com to explore, learn more, download these available resources, interact with them. There's also an opportunity to sign up for more information to come directly to your inbox. We also are on social media, so you can follow HonestlyHD to stay updated with the latest information about HD Korea. And I know we've talked about it a few times, but sharing your story for stories of hope there isn't exactly a way to email us, but we are at all of the events. So if there is anybody who is interested in sharing their story, we are more than welcome to come up to our table, talk with us, and we can make that happen. Get your story submitted and on the internet for others to read, and hopefully inspiring others who read it.
Yeah, I think that's really important. And for those of you who are in the U.S., Teva is actively at many, if not all, of the HD-related events. So this is an important thing to stop by, say hi, learn more in person, meet the players behind the scenes. And then also, if you have any feedback or want to get further involved, that's a great way to start that conversation as well.
Yeah, we are open to feedback, because that's how things happen. That's how the career planning tool happens. That's how honestlyhd.com came to life. So the more feedback and the more information is always best for us too.
Absolutely. Well, Christine, any other things that you want to share before we say our goodbyes?
No, I just want to thank you, Jenna. Thank you for having me. This is awesome. I'm excited to get more info about HDYO out there and continue to be part of the community.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Christine. And thanks to the team at Teva for putting this important resource available. You can find out more at honestlyhd.com. If you have any questions about this or need some extra support or just want to reach out, please don't ever hesitate to reach out to HDYO. We are always an email away. So thank you all so much for listening today. And I hope you have a great day and take care.